Hello, tubers, and welcome once again to Conundrum Contingencies. I'm your host, the good Reverend Garland, and I hope all of you guys are doing well. Now, the subject of this video is sound, you know. Like beauty, sound is in the ear of the beholder. Now, I remember when my grandmother gave me my first boombox, I remember the first song that I recorded. I remember the last song that I uploaded today. First song I ever recorded up in KC was Material Girl by Madonna. And the last song that I uploaded was Jump My Bone by E-40. And some of you guys say, well, I would have preached when I listened to that, but never mind all that. As poetic as Randy Travis was, and as songful as Crystal Gayle is, for them, for some people, their music is just rubbish. For some people, LL Cool J's music is trash. Some people don't like Sir Mix a lot, and This American, and that's their choice. But there could come a time where what is typically a very beautiful sound could be the stuff that nightmares are made of. Now, I've got a clip for you, and the sound that I'm about to play for you be a wonderful song on a honeymoon night, be a great song. Well, it'd be a great sample, be great sounds for a prom night. It might be wonderful if somebody owed you some money or somebody owed you some kind of debt. Might be nice if this person believed in the golden rule and you didn't. And then the very next day, you heard this sound. But in an SHTF situation, it would be a horrible sound. Now, before we get to the sound itself, I want to let you guys, or remind you guys, that one day the post office may close and not reopen for a while. You know, one day there could be no Walmart.com, no Amazon.com, no eBay. Now, I just took the liberty of ordering this Survivor DVD. It's got 257 different manuals and lots of other different things on there. And so that opens a window for me to do a review on it later. And I also got some speed hooks. But see, right now, I can just easily go to Walmart, go to Kmart, go to a sporting goods store, and I can order as many hooks or buy whatever I want off the shelf. So you need to stock up, but there could come a time where that just doesn't happen. And then you're left holding the bag thinking, wishing, woulda, coulda, shoulda. No, folks, this is gin, but it's not Tang or Red. I drink a little rum, a little beer, and what's on sale. But the topic of this video is sound. And this is something that would normally be a great sound here, but it could turn into a nightmare. Now, unless you're a very innocent man or woman, you should instantly recognize that sound. Now, imagine if you're in the next room hearing that with a sock on your mouth, you're tied up, you're at gunpoint, you're powerless, and can do nothing about it. Or worse still, imagine you're helping create these sounds against your will. Now, there are evil men and women. There are even some bad breaths out there that would set you up. There are people that would kick down your door and literally take everything that you have. Now, as far as conventional means of boxing, fighting, and wrestling, hey, I'm a big advocate for self-defense. I'll put them up in a minute. I will try to be a gentleman and walk away, but it doesn't always work. I have fought multiple adversaries and won. I've broken jaws and raised my hand in victory. I've had some bloody draws, too, against multiple adversaries. And against multiple adversaries, I have got knocked the fuck out. But I'm not advocating anybody be a coward. Now, if you ever read Bruce Lee's fighting method, Bruce Lee said, try to avoid a confrontation against multiple attackers. He said, I'm going to show you how to take a gun from somebody. somebody. I'm going to show you how to take a stick away from somebody. But this should be your last resort in case the technique fails. Now, in the middle of the night, my door goes down. Although I'm an ordained minister, I won't be doing any praying. I'm going to reach for one of these, okay? I hope you got more than one. But if you have none, I suggest you invest in one. Because one day, you know, your Second Amendment rights might be violated. You won't even be able to buy one. And I only advise you to do like some idiots that I know. They only bring the gun out on New Year's, and they only bring it out on the 4th of July. They squeeze off a few rounds and call it good. Your weapon needs to be clean, oiled, and ready to go. I don't know what the laws are in your little town. Safety's off where I live at. And you should get proficient with it. If you can't go into the woods or the desert and pop off a few cans, then you might just have to pony up $20 and go to the range. But again, I want to prepare you for the harsh realities that are about to come. You know. Hey, maybe these aren't the last days. Maybe America isn't headed down a well, a spiral of doom. But if these are the last days, then that means we're headed for a financial and more decline such as these United States have never saw. So I just want to give you guys a little bit of food for thought, and I advise you to seek him while there's still time and stock up while there is still time. You know, Bugs Bunny used to say, I use strategy, but if you're not prepared, you know, you could end up like those boys in